Divine service, morning prayer on page 235, following our opening hymn, hymn 814.
Thank you.
rise for morning prayer.
He is not guilty.
Of whom I am the foremost. But I received mercy for this reason, that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display his perfect patience as an example to those who are to believe in him for eternal life. To the King of apes, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel is according to St. Luke, the 15th chapter. Now the tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to hear Jesus. The Pharisees and the scribes grumbled, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." So he told them this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that was lost." Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one, does not light a lamp and sweep the house and seek diligently until she finds it? And when she has found it, she calls together her friends and neighbors, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the coin that I have lost." Just so I tell you, there is joy before the angels of God over one sinner who repents. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets.
But now in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son.
In the name of Jesus, amen. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. The Venite, a portion of Psalm 95, helps us understand the Good Shepherd theme indicated by our bulletin cover art this day. But Luke 15, 1 through 10 is not the only part of that chapter from Luke that could adorn our preaching and our meditation this day. The unread alternate lesson, the expanded lesson, if you will, for this day, is actually the parable of the prodigal son. We love that one, especially when we're the prodigal and it's time for us to come home. We tend to not like it on the bad days when we're the pouty older brother, not wanting to welcome the prodigal. There's the second parable that Jesus tells in this chapter about a missing coin and a deliberate, intentional search for it all the way to the end about rejoicing. And if this were Lutheranized, the scope of the party to rejoice over the finding of the coin might cost more than the coin itself. But then there is this particular text, the parable of the lost sheep, that I'd like to focus on with you this morning. Tax collectors and sinners were drawing near to Jesus. And on some level, this doesn't feel right. They're sinners. Who are they to think that they could be gathered before the Lord Jesus, the Holy One, Son of God and Son of Man? And that's when our inner Pharisee, the judge kind, not the judge not kind, is at its peak. The Pharisees and the scribes grumbled, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." If Jesus would refuse to meet with sinners, if Jesus would refuse to eat with sinners, then we are all prodigals with zero chance of coming home. So Jesus tells a parable. He tells a parable that they're likely to understand even if they no longer own any sheep and haven't eaten mutton in weeks. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? It's one of the simplest math lessons there is after you can count to 100, right? 99, 100. For the sake of the one, the 99 are left for a time, perhaps in the care of others, since shepherds often took care of 30 to 40 sheep, I am told. But the focus, for that moment, the literal pastoral care is on that one. Maybe you've heard pastors say this several times a year for your entire life. Maybe you've never heard it before. But the word, spelled P-A-S-T-O-R, means shepherd. In Latin, in German, and also in English. A shepherd sometimes leaves the congregation that is doing okay, gathered together, safely around word and sacraments, and goes after the one that we haven't seen in a while. It's even more complicated in the season of COVID. And he goes after the one is lost until a specific condition, right there in the field, until he finds it. It's hard work. It's frustrating work. Those of you who have gone after family members who you love, who haven't been gathered around the Lord's gifts in some time, know what this feels like. Those of you who have been brought home knows the other emotions behind this. Those of you who have served in the church office or as pastors or elders or leaders of the congregation or the Ladies Missionary League know about this too. And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And it looks a little bit like this, our bulletin cover for the day. About 11 years ago, I was searching through the nooks and crannies of Emmanuel Lutheran Church here in Sheridan, trying to get to know the place, in addition to getting to know the people. There were portions of the building I didn't get to explore until just recently, like that attic area underneath the new aluminum cross. I'd forgotten that crawl space was there in the upper room where the confirmation computer lab is. But in one of our storage areas, I found a framed painting. It's our bulletin art. And so I thought, let's hang it by the staircase that leads to pastor's study and someday the downstairs pastor's study. It's the Savior carrying the prodigal sheep home. The sheep in question is not just some dead coin, a piece of metal that can't run away on its own. Though we sometimes think our car keys or our glasses or that piece of paper we're missing does have legs. Sheep have legs. They can go astray, but coins do not. When he is found it, he lays it on his shoulders rejoicing, because this is no mere dead coin, inanimate object. This is a creature. This is a creature with life. And a human sheep is a creature of the Lord with the breath of life in God's image. Rejoicing, full of joy, very active, and it's infectious in a good way. Don't wear masks to cover your joy. Don't hide it under a bushel. When he, the shepherd, comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I found my sheep that was lost." The joy is palpable, like romantic love. Just so, I tell you, Jesus says to the tax collectors, to the sinners who are drawing near to him, to the Pharisees and to the scribes who are grumbling at him, just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. I think we understand the rejoicing over the one who's come home. Of course, there's reason for joy. Sometimes there's paperwork in our line of work. We ask for a transfer from a congregation where the person grew up, was baptized, was confirmed, and sometimes went his or her own way. But there's confusion in many minds, in many hearts, about the 99 in this particular context. We're not talking about the faithful 99 from before, who were left under the care of others, who were left in the comfort of word and sacrament by their Lord Jesus, while their pastor went to seek the one. The 99 righteous persons who need no repentance needs a little bit of a punctuation fix, if you will. You know air quotes? Air quotes. Righteous. So-called righteous. Let's call them the self-righteous. Those that have determined in their heart, their mind, their mirror, that they are righteous by their own standard. Not the Lord's standard. Not the standard of the Ten Commandments. Not the standard of judge not. They're not saying that their sheep is totally white, but at least it's better than that other person over here. The 99 so-called self-righteous persons who don't think they need repentance. Is the phrase closer to comprehension now? Does it make a little more sense? Calling folks sheep is not a compliment. You've heard that before, I know. Those who don't think they need repentance think they are righteous in the eyes of the Lord because of their piety, their dedication, their works. It all gets down to works. And there's the problem. This man receives sinners and eats with them. Thank God. That means there's hope for a preacher, a Christian, a sinner, like me. And if there's hope for me, guaranteed hope, forgiveness, life, salvation, eternity with our good shepherd, who takes the lambs of his flock in his arms of mercy and gathers them home, then there's hope for you and for all who hear the message of Jesus. We learn what kind of Savior, what kind of shepherd this Jesus is. He's a good one. He is good. We are not. So he takes all of us, living lost coins, all of us prodigal sheep, and he leaves heaven, is incarnate in human flesh, and actively comes after you. Imagine instead a different prodigal son parable, where the older brother actually leaves town because he cares. He goes himself into the far-off country of a sinful world, a valley of the shadow of death, if you will. And he drags brother home on his arms, rejoicing. Rejoice with me, for I have found my brother, the prodigal sheep who was lost. This is what Jesus does for you, for us, in his incarnation, his Christmas, his birth, his life, his ministry, his suffering, his death, his resurrection, and his ascension for you. Our Jesus is the Good Shepherd. Jesus is God, our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. In the name of Jesus, amen. The canticle of morning prayer is the Benedictus. Please stand.
Preserve them from all error, false belief, or other great shame and vice. Fortify them for your vital work through extraordinary difficulties. As they gather together your congregation around your work, bless their preaching and teaching that will lead their hearers to confess with St. Paul that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Defend your holy church throughout the world. Keep her safe from all harm and danger. Defend those who suffer for your name's sake, and give them boldness to confess the faith no matter the consequences. Even as we love life and strive to preserve it, do not let us love this life above the eternal life won for us in Christ Jesus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless our country as we prepare to celebrate Independence Day, that we would cherish the freedoms we have and always stand ready to defend them. Give wisdom to all those who have been placed in authority over us, that as they strive to preserve life and livelihood in our land, they would do it with an eye towards sustaining the freedoms enjoyed in our nation, especially our religious liberty. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Support and defend all who face trials and tribulations of any kind, those in any want or need, those who are burdened with animosity in the home and community, those who are suffering from illness, loneliness, depression, anxiety, unemployment, or any other affliction. We especially pray for Lucille, Gordon, Nancy, Patricia, LaVon, Beverly, Mary, Lisa, Richard, Melissa, and Clinton and Nettie. Give them strength and endurance in the midst of all difficulty. And if it be your will, grant restoration and relief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Holy Father, receive our prayers this day for all who have fallen asleep in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to an eternal life in Christ. Keep us in that same faith and hope that we rise with them on the last day and enter the inheritance prepared for us before the foundation of the world was laid. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, you have safely brought us to the beginning of this day. Defend us in the same with your mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, nor run into any kind of danger, but that all our duties, being ordered by your governance, may be righteous in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
To our Lord, entrusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Good morning to you again. I just want to direct your attention to the bulletin for an updated announcement for services in the future. We will continue to have both 8 a.m. worship service and 10:30 a.m. worship service in July. Whether or not we will have Sunday school in adult Bible class is yet to be determined. So just note that update to the update from last week's update. The Lord be with you all.